Hi again, it's Dan Carra at the CES Robotics Tech Zone, the Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas, Nevada. We've had a very exciting day viewing a number of robots at this particular event, particularly in the Robotics Tech Zone. One example is the new relaunched Pleo robot, this small baby dinosaur robot. That's a class of robots called a robotic smart toy. So what they've done is taken traditional robotic form factors, say a teddy bear or a little robot or sometimes a knight or something like that, or a soldier, and brought it into a robot. By robot, I mean they've added sensor technologies as well as some sort of intelligence and then some sort of movement. And those are the three things you need for any class of robot. So again, they built in a number of sensors, feedback from those sensors, the intelligence uses that, makes some sort of decisions, and then they were able to move in those decisions and act in the real world. And that's what differentiates it, those from traditional toys, which don't have intelligence or movements, or a new virtual toy, such as video games, which might have virtual movement and a little bit of intelligence, but not a whole lot of sensors. Again, a new class of products. We've also seen, again, the Paro robot coming from Paro USA, which is a home healthcare robotic used in elder care centers and also sometimes with folks suffering from autism. Again, a robot which is specifically designed to bring out human emotions that you can interact with in a very close way. And it doesn't have to do a whole lot. It doesn't have to speak to you. It doesn't have to move a great distance. But again, it has those sensors. It can interpret that data coming in from the sensors, whether it's someone speaking or someone's rubbing its head or petting its belly, and interact in some way, either with a whine if it's upset or with a type of purring if it's happy. Again, we've also seen the same sort of thing with other types of robots coming from BeatBots. With that particular robot, again, it doesn't move a whole lot, but it does have sensors into it. It can position and recognize faces and will turn to those faces and make different types of movements or make different types of sounds so that it appeals to people, and in fact, people find it very, very appealing. Another type of robot we saw here was the iFairy robot coming across, which is basically a robot which is used to, again, communicate with people. And here it's less of sensor interaction. They can tell when people's come up to it and then either play something or say something that's appropriate for that time. So a variety of robotic types here. By consumer robotics, for the most part, we're talking about robots that are purchased by individuals when used in the home. In some cases with Paro or with iFairy or with Pleo, they might be purchased by larger organizations. But main thing is they interact with people in a one-to-one way, and that's what makes them a consumer robot. So again, a variety of interesting robots here, and from the first day of the show, we've had a lot of interesting sights to see. Certainly new products being released by Evolution Robotics with their Mint floor cleaner, and then Nitto Robotics with a different type of a vacuuming robot to compete with the Roomba. So again, a lot of excitement here, and again, there'll be more of it coming in next year. You can read about all of this on robotics.trends.com, www.robotics.trends.com, or in Robotics Business Review at www.robotics.businessreview.com. Go there to sign up for our newsletters, both Robotics Trends newsletter and the Robotics Business Review newsletter, where you can keep on top of all of this information, particularly as it pertains to the growth of new businesses and new marketplaces and new technologies. Thanks a lot, and talk to you later. Bye-bye.